inside Wells Fargo Arena. Let's start things off in Class 3A. Solon got bumped in this round just a season ago. Today, battling Des Moines Christian. Early on, Solon getting up and down the floor with Haley Miller. A pass ahead to Kobe leads for the easy lay-in. Later, it's Miller in the corner. She bangs home a three, and on their next trip down the floor, it's Miller times two. Another three gets the Spartan faithful on their feet, and those fans will be back because Solon is headed to the state championship game after winning 49-25.
I wanted to do something special for Solon. I wanted to do something special for this town, and just to be able to go out there with some of my best friends and get to the state championship game is just, I'm just so blessed. I'm so incredibly blessed.
Solon would play the winner of this one between Mount Vernon and Esterville Lincoln Central. Mustangs down eight. They feed it to their big down low, Chloe Meester, who turns and gets two, but Mount Vernon would find themselves down 16 at the half. They kept fighting. This shot is off the mark, but Peyton Simpson is there for cleanup, getting the putback. Then she gets a wide open look behind the key and drains it, but the damage was too deep as Mount Vernon falls 45-37.
A lot of credit to our kids. I mean, they really fought and battled to the end, and we tried to scrap and claw and give ourselves a chance. You know, as we told them in the locker room, like, if you're going down, man, you'd like to go down at Wells Fargo Arena. So they got a lot to be proud of here this season.
And after winning their 21st straight game, Cedar Falls looked to extend their streak in the Class 5A semifinals against Dowling Catholic. Both defenses were stingy to start, but the Tigers take an early lead as Sophie Stanek splashes in the corner triple. Drake signee Grace Knutson driving along the baseline kisses two off the glass to keep this a one-point game. Gabby Hanks gets the feed in an open look and sinks three, and Cedar Falls would trail by 1 point at the half. But the Maroons couldn't miss from three-point range to start the third. They got up by as many as 17. Knutson led the Tigers with 20 points, but Cedar Falls' season comes to an end as they fall by 11 and finish with an impressive 23-2 overall record.
We just don't give up. We don't really care what people say. We don't really care that we get the 7th seed. You know, we love to be the underdog. We kind of have the target on our back all season on the MVC. So just to come in and compete and really just show people wrong and show that we can play with anyone, just what shows what this program is about.
Thanks, Chelsea. A busy night session as well. Two area teams trying to punch their ticket into the 4A finals. Number one seed, undefeated Clear Creek Amana in a battle with North Polk. Clippers down two at halftime, but in the third, Ava Locklear catches fire. The senior muscles down the lane, gets the bucket to go, plus another at the free throw line. Fourth quarter, North Polk punches back. It turns into a one-point Clipper lead. CCA needs a stop, and they get it. After the Bliss-Beck rebound, they quickly swing it up the floor. Avery Lauer with the bucket to put her team up three in the final seconds, and things were getting a little wild in the Clippers student section. So up three, the Clippers foul. North Polk shooter, she makes the first, intentionally misses the second. Lauer comes down with the biggest rebound of her life, and Clear Creek Amana is going to the state title game.
I just read the rebound, and I wanted this so bad. You know, I knew we had to get a stop, so, you know, I'm so glad I was the one who got the rebound.
In the other semi, undefeated Waverly-Shell Rock in a slugfest with Bishop Heelan. Points at a premium. At only 5'9", Sydney Bieneman played like a giant. 15 rebounds, 6 on the offensive glass. She gets 2 of her 7 points here. Gohawks have a 7-point lead at the break. Fourth quarter now, Waverly-Shell Rock just had nothing going offensively. Caitlin Egana goes into I'll-do-it-myself mode. Over the double team, she gets it to go. But Heelan gets it to within 1. A muddy game basically turned into a free-throw contest in the final minutes, but the Gohawks were up for it. And despite Egana having their only field goal of the fourth quarter, Waverly-Shell Rock holds on and they get to play one more day. The Gohawks are headed to the state championship. And how about this? Waverly-Shell Rock and Clear Creek Amana, not only are they both undefeated, they're both playing for their school's first ever state championship. It'll be appointment television on Saturday. Reporting from Wells Fargo Arena, Jack Lito, KCRG TV9 Sports.